Please do subscribe to our Nehra Classes YouTube channel and also turn on the bell notifications to receive the updates of our videos directly in your device.
Hello friends, I Vikas Nehra welcome you all to our Nehra Classes YouTube channel. Friends, in today's tutorial we will learn how can we use the SAR utility to monitor the system performance in Linux. Actually, SAR stands for System Activity Report. It is a Unix system V-derived system monitor command that is used to report on various system loads including CPU activity, memory, paging, interrupts, device load, network and swap space utilization. SAR uses /proc file system for gathering the information. For today's tutorial, I am going to use this machine that is running on RHEL 8.2, and in this machine I have already configured the local YAML repository from where I will install the packages for SAR utility. So without wasting time, let's get started. First of all, we will log in the machine as the root user and we will make sure that the local YAML repository is properly configured here. Here you can see that I have already configured the local YAML repository in my machine. If you don't know how to configure it, you can watch my videos. I will provide you the link in the description as well as in the I button. And after that, we will verify whether the sysstat package is installed in our machine or not. This package is responsible for the working of SAR command. This package is not installed here. So now in the next step, we can install it from the local YAML repository. So here we will execute dnf install sysstat. This command will install the required packages that are used for the proper working of the SAR command. Now we have successfully installed the package here. After that, in the next step, we can start the sysstat service. Systemctl start sysstat. We have started the service. Now we can enable the service as well so that it can start at its own on rebooting the machine. We will verify the status of the service as well by systemctl status command. Here the service is up and running. Now we will verify the version of the SAR package that we have installed in our machine. So here we can execute SAR-V and it is showing the version as 11.7.3. Now we can execute the SAR command to check the statistics. But before that, let me show you how can we set the cron tab to execute the SAR utility at every 10 minutes to generate the report on daily basis. So for that, we can open the etc/cron.d sysstat file in VI editor. If it is not there, you can create it, and there you can go in the insert mode and you can set the cron tab in this file. Here I have set the cron tab which will execute the tool in the background at every 10 minutes automatically, and I have also set the another cron tab that will generate a daily summary of the processes accounting at 2355. Now we can save this file and we can verify it. Let me use the cat command and see the details of this file. /etc/cron.d sysstat. Here it is. Now we can proceed further. Let me show you the basic configuration file for sysstat or the SAR utility that resides in etc sysconfig, and the name of the file is sysstat. This is the configuration file for the SAR tool. In this file, you will find different options, so you can use them as per the requirement. Here it is showing that history is equal to 28, compress after 31 means it can compress the old logs of the SAR after 31 days. So we can enable it or disable the options as per the requirement by using this file. Now we are not going to make any changes there. Now I will show you how can we generate CPU report on the fly 6 times at every 3 seconds. For that we can simply execute SAR command, and after the SAR command we can mention 3 and 6, because we want to generate the report on the fly 6 times at an interval of 3 seconds. Press enter, so it will generate the report. You can see this 2 times, 3 times, 4 times, 5 times, one more time, and 6 times. And here it is the average of all the details. It shows us the CPU status, percentage user, CPU details, system details, input output details. So we can change it as per the requirement. Means if I want to execute it at a interval of 4 seconds, so here I can mention SAR 4, and how many samples I want to collect, I can mention that in those samples here. Let us suppose I want to collect 5 samples, so I can execute it in this way. Now the next example of SAR command is, if we want to save SAR output to a file, so for that we can use option hyphen O. Let me show you. We can mention SAR 25, then option hyphen O, then we will mention the path of the file where we want to save it, dev null, because we don't want to see the details on the terminal here, and press enter. So it will generate the file inside temp directory with the name as data, and it will print the output of the SAR command in this file. Now how can we read this file, or how can we collect the data from the SAR files? So for that we can execute SAR hyphen F command, and we can specify the name of the file after that. Let me show you. Our command has been successfully executed. Now we can collect the data. So here we will specify SAR hyphen F and the details, the exact location of the file. So it will print the details that are there in this file. If we will try to open this file with the help of cat command like this, you will not be able to see the details. You will have to use only the SAR hyphen F option there. Now the third example is, how can we generate memory usage report using option hyphen R. So option hyphen R we use in the SAR command, which is used to generate the memory usage report. So here we can mention SAR hyphen R, and then we can mention the interval and the samples timing like this. So it will generate the detailed report for the memory usage. In this output, the KB commit and percentile commit are the overall memory used, including RAM and swap. Here these are. Okay. Now the next example of the SAR command is, how can we generate paging statistics report? So for that we can use option hyphen B after the SAR command. It displays the paging statistics. SAR hyphen B, and then we can mention the details, means the interval and the samples, number of samples. So it will print the paging details. In this report, MAJ flats shows the major faults per second, mean number of pages loaded into the memory from the disk, and percentile VMEFF indicates the number of pages scanned per second. If its value is 100%, it is considered okay, and when it is below 30, then there is some issue with the virtual memory. So here is the output of the swap statistics. Now the next example of SAR command is how can we generate block device statistics, and for that we can use option hyphen D in the SAR command like this. SAR hyphen D hyphen P, and after that we can mention the interval and the number of samples. Press enter, and this time it will print the details. This time it is printing the details for block device statistics. Now the next example is how can we generate network statistics report, and for that we can use option hyphen N. Let me show you how can we do that. After the SAR command we can use option hyphen N, and we can mention the name, or we can include all like this, so it will print the details of the network statistics. Now one more important command that we use with SAR command, how can we read SAR log, and for that we can use option hyphen F. This command is very important to read the logs for the past uses of the machine. Let us suppose if I want to check and analyze the last week performance of my machine, I can simply use this option there to read the log files. Actually, the SAR logs are there in var log directory. If you will go to the location var log, there you will find a directory with name as SA, and this directory contain the logs of SAR command. So let's move in this directory, and if you will list the contents of this directory there, you will find several files starting with name SA, and after that you will find a number in their name. This number represents the logging date. Let us suppose if today is 12th of October, that means this file is containing the logs of today. So we can use these files to read or analyze the performance of our machine on that particular date. So how can we achieve that? We can simply execute the SAR command to read these files. If I want to read this file, I can use SAR hyphen R hyphen F and the exact location, that is var log SA, and the name of the file. Press enter, so it will print the details, those are there in this file. So by this method we can analyze the past performance of our machine. So guys, that's it about the SAR command, which can you use for system performance monitoring, and with this command you can check and analyze the performance of your machine and you can improve it. Hope you will find this video useful. If you like it, then do share it with your friends and colleagues. And if you are new on our channel, then please subscribe us and turn on the bell notification for the latest updates of our videos. I'll see you in the next session. Till then, bye bye. Jai Hind. Vande Mataram.